Welcome to the Daytona Speedway here in beautiful Florida, checking out the new RF and audio and comms over fiber system designed by Gotham Sound being implemented at Motocross. I'll take you through it. Let's talk specs. We've got to get two channels of wireless audio with push-to-talk private line communication, two channels of IFB for talent, and six channels of comms all over this giant speedway. Coverage has been broken up into two zones. The first zone is pit road, and the second is the paddock. To accomplish these massive cable runs, we've had to tap into the 3 miles of fiber that Daytona Speedway already has installed. All right, so let's start on the control room side. So for RF over fiber, we've got the Wisycom MFL. We've got a special RRR mode, RRRR, four Rs. So that means that there are four RF over fiber receivers in there. We've got that outputting into a MAT 244 to give us up to four different zones. We are using three of them. Two of them over fiber, and one of them is a local to the truck for testing. And then we're going out into the MRK980 receiver, two-channel receiver. And the great part about this is that it has different outputs for the private line mode. Talking about comms, we're using the FreeSpeak Edge. Great thing about the Edge is it integrates wonderfully with the IP transceivers. Going around to the back, we've got a custom patch panel, which honestly was one of the more fun things to make. Just very satisfying to have everything labeled. We have, as I said, two different fiber zones, but we actually made enough to be able to have up to four fiber zones, so for future expansion if they want to add more. And you can also see these SESCOM boxes. They do audio over fiber. And this is how we manage the IFBs, more about that later. But basically, it's got two channels both ways. There's a sister box on the other side, and we're gonna go to one of the pods now. All right, so heading over to the first zone. The closest one is the truck loading and unloading zone. So we'll walk over there and give you a peek at what that pod looks like. Walking up to where our first pod is by the media center, probably about 500 feet away. Not the furthest fiber run your other encounter, but you can see we've got our antennas up there. There's two Wisycom LFAs bagged and secured on a single stand. This is the zone for the truck. And then our pod is right over here. Okay, starting with the back panel of this pod. So we've got another custom designed patch panel, which was one of the most exciting things for me to say again. We've got our two receiver antenna inputs, IFB transmit antenna output, and then the comm transceiver corresponding with the fiber feeds. And then if the IFB from this rack has been pulled to go to the pit row rack, so it's not in here, but that is connected, or would be connected, to Electro IFB T4, cranking at 250 milliwatts. And then obviously being fed by this SESCOM. This is the pair of the one back at the control room. Okay, and then on the front, you see your two Wisycom BFL transmitters. You've got this box here that's converting the fiber and also providing PoE for the ClearCom transceiver, which is the IP transceiver. And then the cool thing about this is all DC powered. So right now, obviously, we've got an AC plug, but if for any reason they need to throw this pod down anywhere, everything's running through this PSC power distro, and we've got an Anton Bauer gold plate here. And not to be outdone, there's a drawer. So the next zone is actually for pit road, which is right behind me. But the interesting thing is the antennas are not in pit road. They're actually on top of the building all the way across the race course. If we zoom in a little bit, you can barely see the antennas. They are up there. They look like little specks. And, surprisingly enough, you get them high, and they're perfect. So providing excellent coverage for the entirety of pit road, which runs pretty darn far, and not just the receive antennas, but also the IFB antennas.
To get from our broadcast truck to the top of the stands, the fiber first runs to the media center, then out to this compound here, and all the way back to the top of the stands. That's about 3 miles of fiber. Since it's so far away, one of our crew members was nice enough to drive me there.
Zone 2, top of the roof, top of the world. I'll show you the antenna placements we looked at from the other side, show you where we were. So here we have our first IFB antenna. Over here is our second IFB antenna. We have our shark fins over there, and you can see the whole speedway from here. No race is going on right now, but our truck is right down there, pretty far away. But you do see pit road over there, and the coverage is perfect. Gonna bring you down and take a look at the pod that we had set up for zone 2. Okay, here's the pod for zone 2. As you can see, it's almost exactly the same, except this one is not using the comms transceiver port, but we still have our two receive antennas now using our IEM antennas. We see we've got two lines coming from the SESCOM. That's really cool that you can get four channels of audio over one fiber. We still have the PSC cart powered, the battery backup, if we so chose. And coming around to the front panel, we see the IFB T4. There's another IFB T4 that was kind of slapped into the back. We have our PoE fiber converter and all of our Wisycom BFLTs. And of course, the drawer. Let's hear what the crew has to say. All right, so I'm here with Tanner and Dee, the RFA2s for this go-round of Daytona. And guys, I just want to ask, like, what do you think people should know about doing a job like this?
Well, from my understanding, when you're working on such a big track with so much going on, and very little organization, you gotta really come in ready for anything. You gotta come in prepared. So you gotta definitely have, you know, your spectrum analyzer. Dee helped me out with that this week. You gotta be ready to deal with stuff. And we got really lucky. We have a lot of RF up in the sky right now. That's giving us great line of sight. That's key. And being able to get our antennas up there with optical fiber, it's just made a huge difference. I mean, from what I understand, the people who were working this system before, they were trying to do it with radios and other types of stuff, and it wasn't cutting the cheese, you know. And our talent this year has been like so grateful for crystal clear audio in their ears and crystal non-breakup audio over the receivers we got now. So I think being prepared for a situation like this is 100% key.
Hey, I like it because there's no copper involved. It's cool because now we can do RF over fiber, and we're sitting down by pit lane. We have antennas on top of the tower and zone 2 by the pits, and we have one copper antenna for local, and it's pretty awesome. It's new to me. I'm learning all the gains and all the structures and stuff, which is going to be a learning curve, but it's my second time using Wisycom, and it's pretty awesome. I dig it. I really do. It's a game changer for a lot of people that you cover, like, we're at the track in Daytona. It's huge. This is huge, man. It's pretty awesome.
All right, so that does it for me here in Florida. Thanks so much for watching. As always, you can follow us on Instagram and Facebook and X. And email us at info@gothamsound.com. And of course, go to gothamsound.tv if you'd like to watch more videos like this. Thanks so much.